So, the next algebraic structure that we want to look at are rings. The rings are a bit more specific than groups again, but they're quite similar. So, a ring is a set again, just like a group, a set, but it has two operations. One we usually denote as addition, and one as multiplication. So, we have a set with elements, and a plus and a times operation on those elements. And the axioms a ring needs to fulfill is that the set with addition is an abelian group, that we're just presented what that is, and R and multiplication is a monoid. We will see what that is in a second. And the other axiom that needs to be fulfilled is that multiplication, so this operation, is distributive. What that means we'll also see on the next slide. So, yeah, the set with the plus operation is an abelian group. The set with the multiplication is a monoid. It's sometimes called a semigroup with identity. So, that means it's also associative, and it has an identity element, but not every element needs to have an inverse. So, a monoid is essentially the same as a group, but without the restriction that every element needs an inverse. For a monoid, it's okay to not have inverses for all elements. So, multiplication is distributive, means we can use the multiplication rules that we have learned in elementary school. So, instead of writing A times this here, we can rewrite it as that. And that's all there is to it. So, another term that you should be familiar with is that ring element. So, an element from the set that is underlying the ring. If it has a multiplicative inverse, it's called a unit. And the set of all units of a ring themselves are a group. So the units of a ring form a group. And now we're ready to look at an even fancier